Welcome all to St. Andrews-Wesley United Church, where we gather on this remarkable day to witness and to celebrate the joining together of two separate lives. We have come to embrace Shane and Adam as they embrace each other in the celebration of marriage. And please know that you are welcome here, whoever you are, whomever you happen to love, wherever you are from, whatever you happen to believe, you are welcome here in this place. And we also recognize that here in this place, long before this building was constructed, there were people who gathered and lived. And so we also recognize the Coast Salish people who have been here for hundreds, literally thousands of years, the Musqueam, the Squamish, and the Tsleil-Waututh. And so today, through readings, through music, but most of all, through your presence, we affirm together in the words of Shane Raman, all lives are evidence of the closest space in which the past and the future exist. All lives are evidence of infinite worth, perfect love, and unlimited potential. All lives are evidence of the nurture of a family, a community, and a circle of friends.
Never thought I'd make it this far. Bless my lucky star. Today, Shane and Adam have invited you here as their beloved family, friends, and community. They are so inspired by your love for them and your support for their potential. Today, they invite you to participate in one of the major milestones of their love story as they honor the struggle that the LGBTQI community continues to experience, and to honor all the love and support that has led them to this day. Please stand with us and sing the following hymn in your program.
Beckons to you, follow him. Khalil Gibran. When love beckons to you, follow him, though his ways are hard and steep. And when his wings enfold you, yield to him, though the sword hidden among his pinions may wound you. And when he speaks to you, believe in him, though his voice may shatter your dreams as the north wind lays waste the garden. For even as love crowns you, so shall he crucify you. Even as he is for your growth, so is he for your pruning. Even as he ascends to your height and caresses your tenderest branches that quiver in the sun, so shall he descend to your roots and shake them in their clinging to the earth. Like sheaves of corn, he gathers you unto himself. He threshes you to make you naked. He sifts you to free you from your husks. He grinds you to whiteness. He kneads you until you are pliant, and then he assigns you to his sacred fire that you may become sacred bread for God's sacred feast. All these things shall love do unto you, that you may know the secrets of your heart, and in that knowledge become a fragment of life's heart. But if in your fear you would seek only love's peace and love's pleasure, then it is better for you that you cover your nakedness and pass out of love's threshing floor into the seasonless world where you shall laugh, but not all of your laughter, and weep, but not all of your tears. Love gives not but itself and takes not but from itself. Love possesses not, nor would it be possessed. For love is sufficient unto love. When you love, you should not say, God is in my heart, but rather, I am in the heart of God. And think not you can direct the course of love, for love, if it finds you worthy, directs your course. Love has no other desire but to fulfill itself. But if you love and must needs have desires, let these be your desires: to melt and be like a running brook that sings its melody to the night, to know the pain of too much tenderness, to be wounded by your own understanding of love, and to bleed willingly and joyfully, to wake at dawn with a winged heart and give thanks for another day of loving, to rest at the noon hour and meditate love's ecstasy, to return home at eventide with gratitude, and then to sleep with a prayer for the beloved in your heart and a song of praise upon your lips.
Thank you. accustomed to courage, exiles from delight, live coiled in shells of loneliness until love leaves its high, holy temple and comes into our sight to liberate us into life.
Love arrives, and in its train come ecstasies, old memories of pleasure, ancient histories of pain. Yet if we are bold, love strikes away the chains of fear from our souls.
We are weaned from our timidity. In the flush of love's light, we dare be brave.
And suddenly we see that love costs all we are and will ever be.
Yet it is only love which sets us free.
I am happy. So am I. So am I. We are happy. We are happy. So what do we do now that we are happy? Wait for Godot. Shane and Adam first heard these words on their first date at a production of Waiting for Godot. That evening would represent a history that they unknowingly shared. They soon realized that years ago, they had been studying at the same college at the same time. They had stood on the same stage, Shane singing Schubert Lieder and Adam as the head of costumes for a play. Though they never met on that stage, their paths would cross again on a different stage. The first time Shane and Adam saw each other, Shane was singing on stage at a Christmas concert and Adam was in the audience. Little did they know that this first sighting would lead to so many more plays, musicals, and concerts experienced together. In the years that followed, Adam and Shane have shared the same stage together. Shane as a performer, composer, and conductor, and Adam as a designer and stylist. One of the tenets of their relationship springs from their shared love of the arts and can be summed up in this quote by Jonathan Larson. The opposite of war is not peace, it's creation.
Of the soul, it's heaven's love.
Shane, you have arrived. And here you are, blessed by this moment, surrounded by the love of your family and friends, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. And so in the presence of God and before your family and friends, I ask you to state your intentions for this marriage. Shane, and do you take this man as your lawfully wedded husband? Do you promise to live together in the covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him all the days of your life? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
And Adam, do you take this man as your lawfully wedded husband? Do you promise to live together in the covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him all the days of your life?
You do.
Friends, family, you who are privileged enough to be here today, having heard the promises expressed by Adam and Shane, I now ask you, and do you promise to be there with Adam and Shane in all of their years of relationship, to celebrate with them in times of joy, and to support them in times of challenge? If so, please say with enthusiasm, we do.
We do.
That counted. These are the vows that Adam and Shane have written for each other. You want this.
Shane, we have always greeted each other with a kiss. It's something that I wait for at the start and the end of my day. I've anticipated that kiss whenever we are together. Whether it be in a private moment in our little home, or in a crowded place, we always greet each other with our kiss. Our kiss represents you as the one I dream about, as the one whose creativity inspires me, the one whose feet I rub and shoulders I soothe, the one I call my best friend. The one I want to please, whom I pour my heart out to, the one who keeps me in my place and encourages me to grow, who brings me comfort, the one who always holds my hand, the one who stands up for me and us, who has learned to call himself a proud gay man. Without your kiss, the ground would thaw, the rain would fall, the grass would grow. Without your kiss, the seeds would root, the flowers would bloom, the children would play. Without your kiss, the eyes would gaze, the legs would walk, the lungs would breathe. But it would all mean nothing without your kiss. My vow is to keep kissing you, and for you to always know what our kiss means.
Amen.
I believe that we are called to search for our lives and to discern who is the best fit for love and companionship and make wise decisions about who we let into our hearts. In the early years of my life, I knew that love was meant for everyone else, but I did not think it was meant for me. When we met, your very demeanor showed me not only that I could be loved in the way that I had dreamed of, but how to love you and how to love myself. You have shown me my own capacity and our capacity to love each other and how that can help soothe a hurting world. This is not a moment of grand gestures and idealist thinking, but a moment of preparing for our future. I wish to love you, to know you, to see you, and to accept you for who you are. I will treat you with kindness and seek to discern the wisdom of when to pull and when to push, when to speak and when to stay silent, when it's about me and when it's about you. I know that our road will be full of joy and sorrow, challenges and celebrations, and I vow today, here, that this love will be my only love, and I will make my home in your heart from this day forward.
A history, one ring already in existence and one specifically designed. These rings represent the wearer in ways that only the beloved can know. Oh, that's really loud. Shane's ring is a curated vintage white gold ring crafted in the Edwardian style with a central European cut diamond flanked with four smaller diamonds. A detailed fan filigree motif tapers to an almost invisible band. Adam's ring is an endless circle of diamonds which refracts a continuous circle of light. With no beginning and no end, this minimal and infinity design begins the first chapter of the history of this ring. On Monday, March the 2nd, 2015, Shane waited with the Eternity Band at Le Marché Saint-Georges, surrounded by candles, white lilies, and vintage silver vases. Later that night, Adam produced the vintage ring. Enveloped by this song, they professed their love to each other and began the next chapter of both of the ring's histories.
Thank you.
Adam have selected rings as a symbol of their vow. And the ring is an ancient symbol, blessed and simple. May it be a reminder to you both that your love, like the sun, illumines, that your love, like arms that embrace, is a grace upon this world, and that your love is always encircled by God's abiding love for you. And so, Adam, I invite you to take Shane's ring. And as you slip it on Shane's finger, please repeat after me.
Shane, I give you this ring.
Shane, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am, I honor and cherish you. And Adam, I give you this ring.
Adam, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am, I honor and cherish you.
May God bless these two lovers and the love that is between them. May they know a deep peace all the days of your life and much joy.
Until we could, Richard Blanco. I knew it then, in that room where we found for the first time our eyes, and everything, even the din and the smoke of the city around us, disappeared, leaving us alone, as if we stood the last two in the world left capable of love. Or as if two mirrors, face to face, with no end to the light our eyes could bend into infinity. I knew, since I knew you, but we couldn't.
I caught the sunlight pining through the shears, traveling millions of dark miles simply to graze your skin, as I did that first dawn I studied you sleeping beside me. Yes, I counted your eyelashes, read your dreams like butterflies flitting underneath your eyelids, ready to flutter into the room. Yes, I praised you like a majestic creature my God forgot to create, till that morning of you suddenly tamed in my arms, first for me to see, name you mine. Yes, to the rise and fall of your body breathing, your every exhale, a breath I took in as my own, wanting to keep even the air between us as one. Yes, to all of you. Yes, I knew. But still, we couldn't.
I taught you to dance salsa by looking into my Caribbean eyes. You learned to speak in my tongue while teaching me how to catch a snowflake in my palms and love the gray clouds of your gray hometown. Our years began collecting in glossy photos, timelining our lives across shelves and walls, glancing back at us embracing in some sunset, more captivated by each other than the sky brushed plum and rose. Us claiming some mountain that didn't matter much as our climbing it together. Us leaning against columns of ruins as ancient as our love was new, or leaning into our dreams at a table flickering candlelight in our full mooned eyes. I knew me as much as us, and yet we couldn't.
Though I forgave your blue eyes turning green each time you lied, but kept believing you. Though we learned to say good morning after long nights of silence in the same bed. Though every door slam taught me to hold on by letting us go, and saying you're right became as true as saying I'm right. Till there was nothing a long walk couldn't resolve. Holding hands and hope under the street lights, lustering like a string of pearls guiding us home. Or a stroll along the beach, the sea washed out by our smiles, our laughter roaring louder than the waves. Though we understood our love was the same as our parents, though we dared to tell them so, and they understood. Though we knew, We couldn't. No one could.
When the fiery kick lines and fires were set for us by our founding mother fathers at Stonewall, we first spoke defiance. When we paraded glitter, leather, and rainbows made human, our word became pride down every city street, saying, just let us be. But that wasn't enough. Parades became rallies, bold words on signs and mouths, until a man claimed freedom as another word for marriage, and he said, let us in. We said, love is love. Proclaimed it into all eyes that would listen at every door that would open until no's and maybes turned into yeses. Town by town, city by city, state by state, understanding us. And the woman who dared say enough until the gavel struck into law what we always knew.
Love is the right to say, I do.
I do.
I do.
And I do want us to see every tulip we've planted come up spring after spring. 100 more years of dinners cooked over a shared glass of wine, and 1,000 more movies in bed.
I do, until our eyes become voices speaking without speaking. Until like a cloud meshed into a cloud, there's no more you, me, our names useless.
I do want you to be the last face I see, your breath, my last breath.
I do.
I do and will.
And will for those who still can't vow it yet, but know love's exact reason as much as they know how a sail keeps the wind without breaking.
Or how roots dig away into the earth.
Or how the stars open their eyes to the night.
Or how a vine becomes one with the wall that it loves.
Or how, when I hold you, you are rain in my hands.
In the beauty of this ceremony, it seems very clear to me that what we are doing today is celebrating love, celebrating the love of Adam and Shane, of course, but more than that, also celebrating the love of friends and family that support them. We also are celebrating that we live in a time and a place where they can openly and publicly celebrate their love together. We're celebrating as well a love of music and all that is good and beautiful in this world, all that enlivens and moves the heart. In short, we are celebrating the source of love itself that wends its way into our heart and moves through each and every one of us. And as you may have already ascertained, theirs is no ordinary wedding celebration. Because not only is it a celebration of music and community, it's also a statement. And this ceremony of music and readings, rituals and vows, we are proclaiming that the love Adam and Shane share is beautiful and good. We're proclaiming to the world that in the end, love wins. Love wins no matter your sexual orientation or gender identity. Love wins whether or not the state recognizes it, whether or not a culture approves, whether or not a religion blesses it. Love wins. And so we thank you, Adam and Shane, for sharing with the world something that is desperately needed and so commonly longed for, a love that is genuine and true, a love marked by tenderness and respect, a love shared with laughter, joy, and skin-tingling delight. And so to honor this love, to proclaim love to the world, to pray for the shining of love and peace in a world too often marred by ignorance and discrimination, by barriers and prejudice, we light these candles of connection. Because countless people have touched the lives of Adam and Shane. Most are known to them, and others have affected their lives even without their knowing. Some of those people are here, and some have made a decision not to attend today's celebrations. Others are here only in spirit, though their lives and decisions have vastly affected the lives of Adam and Shane. And so today, we wish to honor all of you here by lighting candles, signifying the light that you have shone into the life of Adam and Shane. Today we remember that this fight for equality for all peoples is ongoing, and that we have the power to help those here and in other countries who are being harmed and killed based on who they love. light this second candle to remember those that we love who have passed on from this life into the mystery of the next. Without them, our lives could have taken a very different turn, and we would have missed out on the richness that they brought to us. Our memories of beauty and fun, loss and challenge have shaped us into who we are today, and we are so grateful to you. We remember you, we feel you, and thank you for being here with us, especially today. Sign of hope as we travel into the future. We remember our loved ones who have chosen not to be here, and we pray for acceptance and reconciliation on all sides. For those we have yet to meet and those challenges we have yet to face, we light this candle to remember that our love will be our bond going forward, and that out of our love will grow family and friends and community. As we walk a path of peace into the future, we hope that the world will know us by our love and our creativity, increasing peace in our world and peace in our time. And as a sign of this hope, we pass this flame to you.
Reading from Isaiah chapter 11. Out of the stump of David's family will grow a shoot. Yes, a brand new branch bearing fruit from the old root. And the Spirit of the Lord will rest on him.
The Spirit of wisdom and understanding.
The Spirit of counsel and might.
The Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord.
He will delight in obeying the Lord.
He will not judge by appearance, nor make a decision based on hearsay.
He will give justice to the poor and make fair decisions for the exploited. The earth will shake at the force of his word, and one breath from his mouth will destroy the wicked.
He will wear righteousness like a belt and truth like an undergarment.
In that day, the wolf and the lamb will live together.
The leopard will lie down with the baby goat.
The calf and the yearling will be safe with the lion, and a little child will lead them all.
The cow will graze with the bear.
The cub and the calf will lie down together.
The lion will eat hay like a cow.
The baby will play safely near the hole of a cobra.
Yes, a little child will put its hand in a nest of deadly snakes without harm. Nothing will hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain. For as the waters fill the sea,
so the earth will be filled with people who know the Lord.
I invite you to join us as you're able as we sing.
Somewhere in the middle of the Caribbean Sea, at around 1 a.m., under a full sky of stars, a couple waltzes on the top deck of a ship. No one else, except for this couple, is enjoying the warm breeze and the cloudless sky. An orchestral waltz is heard through the ship's speakers, and the couple is holding each other and laughing as they try and falter through the steps of the waltz. Shane and Adam are at times looking into each other's eyes, and at other times marveling at the canopy of stars above them. They stop swaying to the music in a moment of silence. "I want to remember this moment exactly as it is," says Shane. "I've never experienced a more romantic or beautiful moment than this." They look at each other, then up to the sky. If ever there is a time that we are fighting, or a far distance from each other, or simply missing each other, think of this moment. Come to this moment, and I will meet you on the top deck of this ship. In our memories and our minds, we will always be together.
I invite Missy and Emily to come forward, Shane and Adam, as we sign the documents. And as we sign, I invite you to extinguish your candles carefully, but don't extinguish the light. Grooms, I invite you to turn and face your friends and your family. The grooms stand before those that they love and those that love them. You are the people that have raised them, taught them, supported them, and shaped them. Most importantly, you have given them not only the capacity to love, but to understand love and the desire to return it. Because of that, they're able to stand across from each other now to take the limitless wealth that you have all given them in spirit, in time, in love, and return it, not just to themselves, not just to you, but to the memory of those past, to the community, those that will meet, that they will meet in the future, those who will become their family. Without everyone here today, the experiences of the grooms wouldn't be as rich or as life-giving. And for that, Shane and Adam, knowing that language often fails emotion, simply say thank you. And Adam and Shane, I'd like to share with you now an ancient blessing that comes from the Hebrew scriptures that has been repeated over thousands of years and down the hallways of history. And now may it fall upon you and reach your heart. May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May God look upon you with kindness and bring you that peace that passes all understanding. Amen. And now Shane and Adam, with the exchange of rings and the promises made before your family and friends and in the presence of God, and by the power invested in me by God and the province of BC, I am delighted to announce that you are now legally married, now husbands one to each other, and you may kiss as a seal of your vow. And friends, it is my delight to present to you Shane and Adam Raman Dickson, husbands for life.